Awareness Day, a human being who needs no introduction, the mayor of St. Paul, Mayor Melvin Carter!
Thank you.
This is so exciting. Mayor Carter, thank you for joining us. We are celebrating Mental Health Awareness, and mental health is health. And we would love to hear from you why mental health awareness is important to you and to the city and the state.
Well, first of all, thank you for being here. Thank you for doing this. Thank you all for taking your time to kind of be here and to be a part of this conversation. Mental health is health. That's such a simple concept. And can you just turn around and show your shirt? Give a round of applause to this concept. The reason this is important to me is there's no short explanation. I've seen in my personal life, I've seen in my family life, the impacts that mental health crises and mental health challenges can have on individuals, on families. And I've seen both as a city council member, as a member of the governor's staff, and now in my role as mayor, the impacts that mental health concerns have on us. That old stigma, that old, you know, get it together, that old you can do it, is one of the most dangerous things that we can ascribe to as a community. You know, they say, I've heard people before say that mental health is a silent killer, that mental illness is a silent killer. That's not true. It's us that's silent. And we can't afford to be silent anymore. And so the reason this is important to me, Claire, is because as we build a city that works for all of us, as we make sure that we're putting all of our young people, all of our families, all of our businesses, all of our neighborhoods on the path to a bright and successful and vibrant future, there's nothing more important than we can do than start with our own mental, emotional, and chemical health to ensure that we're on the path to being able to secure our brightest future.
That's right. How about that? And Mayor Carter, what we want to do is try to really stop saying stigma. It's not really about stigma, it's about discrimination.
That's right.
We have to have parity in mental health and chemical health, and we have to assure, just like Mayor
That's
Carter
right.
said, that we are talking about this with our neighbors, with our community members, with our families, and most importantly, with our elected officials, so that we can encourage them to invest in building our mental health system.
That's right, and I appreciate you saying that. You know, we're in the state of former U.S. Senator Paul Wellstone,
yes.
who fought hard for that parity on a national level, who provided that leadership on that parity, and that's so critically important. I want to share with you something that we're doing in St. Paul. In my budget proposal that I just presented to our city council a couple of weeks ago, we put in that proposal funding for mental health co-responders to be right out in the city,
Woo!
Right out in the community with our police officers to ensure that we encounter people in crisis. We have the capacity, the resources, and the assistance to connect people who need help to the resources and the help that they need.
Okay.
So that's one thing we're working on right now.
So what exactly does that mean?
Sorry?
What exactly does that mean? How are you doing
what is, that's a great question. The question is, what exactly does that mean? You know the saying, if all you have is a hammer, everything looks like a nail? Well, we have our police officers, and they do excellent work for our community. They go out there, and they have handcuffs, and they have firearms, and they have weapons. We need to know that we have more tools than that. I'd like to see our police officers having access to mental health professionals, people who have cultural skills and language skills and degrees and real professional backgrounds to be able to connect people who are in crisis to all of the different support systems that we have, to whatever it is, to housing, to be able to connect them to supports and things like that that exist across our community so that we can ensure that we're connecting people to help and not to deeper crisis.